गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11, दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट अकाउंटेंसी, चैप्टर नंबर 11, कैश बुक, लेक्चर नंबर 6। बेटा, इन आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सॉल्व टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 10th बी। लेट्स स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 ए, दैट इज गिवन इन योर बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 11.61। रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली, दैट इज एंटर द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शन इन द टू कॉलम कैश बुक ऑफ मिस्टर मोहन। रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली, देन वी विल स्टार्ट सोल्विंग इट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट इज गिवन कैश इन हैंड एंड कैश एट बैंक, बोथ द बैलेंस आर ओपनिंग बैलेंस, सो वी विल डू टू बैलेंस बीडी ऑन Jan 1st। के अंडर कैश विल राइट 2200 एंड अंडर बैंक विल राइट 50,000। फाइन। ऑन Jan 3rd परचेज गुड्स फॉर 75,000, ट्रेड डिस्काउंट इज गिवन, CGST SGST इज गिवन एंड दे आर आस्क्ड यू टू मेक द पेमेंट बाय चेक। सो Jan 3rd बाय परचेजेस अकाउंट दैट इज 60,000, because 75,000 का 20% we will calculate, then it will be 15,000. So when we will deduct 15,000 from 75,000, that will be 60,000. So we will do this entry with rupees 60,000. So here input CGST and SGST will be 6% of 60,000, that will be 3600 and 3600. Fine. Next entry is of Jan 4, sold goods for 40,000, trade discount 15%. So we will do this entry to sales by rupees 34,000 excluding trade discount. Fine. And IGST they have given 12% of 34,000, we will calculate, it will be 4,080. To output IGST we will write on debit side of the cash book. And then Jan 5th, receive the check from Naresh. So we have received a check from Naresh on Jan 5th, so received and endorsement of check will be recorded through journal, we will not record it here. Next one is check received from Naresh endorsed to Suresh. See here, endorsed to Suresh in full settlement office account. So they are saying that it is endorsed to Suresh, so it is the entry of Jan 8th. It will not be recorded in the cash book, as will record it through journal proper. Fine. Next entry is on Jan 10, paid life insurance premium of Mr. Mohan. So it will be drawings account. So entry will be in the cash book of the credit side, drawings account. So and under cash we will write rupees 100. On Jan 13th, the entry is receive the check from Pawan in full settlement of 750. Fine. And 700 we have received. So entry will be to Pawan's account and 700 will go in bank. Fine. And on Jan 16, Pawan's check returned dishonored by bank. They are saying dishonored by bank, so it will be by Pawan's account. So and amount will be 700 will be entered in bank account. Fine. And then beta, on Jan 20th, they are saying deposited into bank balance of cash in excess of rupees 250. So we will keep rupees 250 in cash, and whatever will be in excess, we will record that entry through contra entry. So here the entry will be to cash account by bank account 1850. Fine. And now the balance carried down will be 250 rupees, 22,730, as we are keeping that amount in business. Fine. So and on the first day of next month, that will be Feb 1st, the two balance BD brought down will be 250 rupees in cash and 22,730 will be in bank. Fine. Now see working note. On Jan 5th, checks in hand account debited to Naresh, because Naresh, we have received check from Naresh, so 1,000. Then Naresh endorsed that check to Suresh in full settlement of his account. So on Jan 8th, Suresh account debit to checks in hand to discount received. So here the amount will be checks in hand 1,000 rupees, discount received 50 rupees, and to Suresh will be debited with rupees 1,050. Fine. And here on Jan 16, they are saying Pawan's check returned dishonored by bank. So 50 rupees, as we have allowed discount, we have already done the dishonor entry in the cash book. So we will record this entry of discount here in journal proper, that is in working note On the same date, Jan 16, Pawan's account debited with rupees 50 to discount allowed 50 rupees. Fine. So here the narration will be check received from Pawan dishonored. Fine. So we will record all these entry in the working note in general proper. Now see whatever the cash deposited into bank, that total of the cash column debit side minus total of the cash column credit side plus cash balance maintained, that will be 2200 minus 100 plus 250, that will be 1850. Fine. So on 20th January the amount of cash deposited into bank will be 1850. So we will do contra entry with this same amount. Understood? Now let's read question number 11b, that is first of all they are telling you to start a business with cash, so it will be 50,000. So the entry will be in cash book debit side to capital account 50,000, and the amount will be written under cash. Now December 2nd pays into bank, so it will be contra entry to cash account by bank account with rupees 29,000. On December 3rd received check from Raja and Company and discount allowed. So received check from this Raja and Company, so to Raja and Company account, and amount will be in bank account. Fine. And discount allowed entry we will do in general proper under working notes. Fine. Next one is December 5th withdrew cash from bank for private use, so it will be by drawings, and we will write the amount under bank. On December 10th purchase goods for 1 lakh IGST 18% payment made by check. They have purchased goods. So it will be by purchases account 1 lakh, by input IGST account 18,000 will be written under bank column. On December 12, sold goods for 1,50,000. Trade discount is given 20%, IGST 18%, and they have received payment by check. So it will be, we have done sales, that's why we will record this sales account in the debit side of the cash book. That will be two sales account, 1,20,000 after deducting trade discount. Fine. And what about input IGST? Definitely it will be recorded by two output IGST in the debit side of the cash book with the amount 21,600. Fine. Now the next entry is December 14. That will be received check from Kamla 395 rupees. Definitely if it is received check from somebody, fine. So this entry will be recorded through journal proper, not in cash book. I told you already. Discount allowed also will record through that. So now December 16, that is endorsed. Check Kamla's check endorsed to Bala in full settlement of his account, of her account. 425. This entry also we will record in journal proper in working notes. Now beta, in December 29, they have paid rent by check. So if they have done payment, definitely we will record it on the credit side of the cash book. That will be by rent on December 29th. And if they have made payment by check, definitely we will record it under bank column. On December 30th, deposited into bank the balance of cash in excess of 450 rupees. They have already asked you to prepare, or we can say keep cash in the cash book, because next month we are using this cash by rupees 450. So it will be by balance CD 450. Now we will do all the debit and credit transactions, and whatever the amount will be left over, we will do contra entry with the same amount, like 20,550. So it will be on December 30th, cash account debit to cash account, contra entry, and the amount will be entered in bank, and by bank account it will be contra entry, so amount will be entered in cash account. Fine. Now we will total it up both the sides of cash and bank column. Definitely the balance carried down will be shown on the very first day of the next month, that will be January 1st, to balance BD, 450 rupees cash and 72,710 rupees in bank. Fine. Now let's see what will be recording through working notes under general proper. All the entry of December 14, that is checks in and account debited, Discount allowed account debited to Kamla, that is 395 rupees tax in hand. Discount allowed 15 and to Kamla 410 rupees. And here December 16, that is beta Bala account debited to checks in hand to discount received. So to checks in hand it will be 395, Bala account will be 425. Fine. And in discount received we will do the balance amount of 30 rupees. Fine. Now see question number 12, that is also beta your double column cash book, you have to record it. So first of all let's read the question carefully, then we'll see the solution. Let's see beta. First of all, on June 1st, the balance of cash in hand and overdraft at bank. Definitely, it will be two balance BD, 12,000 under cash and by balance BD, 1,500 under bank. Now, June 2nd, deposited into bank, 10,000 rupees. So, two cash account by bank account, it will be contra entry. On the same date, they have sold goods for cash, 28,000 and paid half the proceeds into bank. So, it will be two sales account, 14,000 under cash and 14,000 under bank. Next, June 3rd, purchase goods for 7,000 from Manoj and company on credit. Definitely, it is the entry of credit. So, are we supposed to record the credit entry in cash book? No. So we will leave this entry. We'll see why Manoj and company whether this account is given later on in some entries or not. Fine. So let's see next entry. June 5th. Received a money order from Suresh. That is 500 rupees. So Suresh account 500 under cash. Received 2800 from Govind and paid 1000 into bank. So to Govind 1800 under cash and 1000 under bank. On June 10, received a check of 7600 from Subhash in full settlement of 8000. So, June 10, the entry will be. They are saying received a check from Subhash. Fine. So, it will be recorded through journal proper because it is a check received. Fine. Next one is June 12, settle the account by Manoj and company by payment. Beta, we have settled the amount by payment cash, half cash, half bank. So, by Manoj and company, 3300 cash, 3300 bank. On June 13, it is saying that check received from Subhash deposited into bank. On June 13. So, it will be, what was the check received from Subhash? That was 7600, so it will be deposited in bank to two checks in hand account debit and amount 7600 will go in bank account. On June 15, it is paid for purchase of machinery by check, so by machinery and it will be going in bank account. June 16, paid wages for the erection of, so by machinery account and the 1000 will go in cash. On 17 June, check issued for 6,000 in favor of Sajdeva and company for the purchase of furniture. So, on 17 June, by furniture account, 6,000 will be entered under bank column. On June 20th, purchase goods from Kalpana Garments from 10,500 on credit. So, by Kalpana Garments, they are saying 10,500 on credit, so we will not record this entry beta. Credit entry we will not record. So on June 20th, on the same date, they are saying the mother and company received a bank draft from it and full settlement of 5,000. So on the same date, we will do the mother and company 4,800 under bank column. Fine. On June 24th, it will be like Kalpana Garments say they have received payment. Bank charge, bank issue a draft in favor of that. Bank ne received, no, not received, it done payment and bank charge 25 rupees. So it will be added in 10,000, so amount will be 10,025, and that will be recorded through credit side by Kalpana Garment. 10,025 is in bank column. On June 26, they are saying drew from bank for petty cash. So buy petty expenses 100 rupees under bank. On June 28, paid salary by check. So buy salary account under bank 6,000. On June 30, bank charges and interest. So both the amount will enter in bank by bank charges by interest account. So now they are saying that deposit into bank after keeping entire balance 4,000 as office. Definitely we will do the same, like we will record both the sides of cash account and then we will leave 4,000. Whatever the amount will be left, we will do contra entry for that amount. So the amount is 10,000. We will do two cash account by bank account. It will be 10,000, 10,000. And later on the balance we will keep in business, that is rupees 4,000, because it is already set. So now we will add both the column of cash, debit and credit both. That will be 28,300. And in bank column, after doing that contra entry, we will find the balance carried down is 1,195. Fine. This balance we will brought down. So bank balance we will brought down on the credit side and cash balance we will brought down under debit side. That will be 4,000 and bank balance will be 1,195. On the very next day, that is July 1st of the next month, in July 2016. Fine. Now we will record the entry to journal proper under working note. Whatever the entry we were not doing in cash book while recording. Let's see. Now see beta, on June 10th, receipt of check from Subhash will be recorded. It will be recorded through general proper, like to checks in hand account debited 7600 to Subhash account. So the narration will be received check from Subhash. So this was the entry that is to be recorded through general proper. Now you have done the question till 12th. Your homework is you have to do till question number 12 in your fair notebook and practice till illustration 12, that is given in your book on page number 11.31. Fine. Along with all the working notes that are given. Fine. That's it for today. I am repeating your homework again. You have to do till question number 12 and practice illustration till illustration 12. Tomorrow we are going to solve question 13. So you will have to practice illustration 13 also along with that.